Becky Hayes here with Miracob Consulting Group, and today we're going to start a series on accountability. And I want to just have a conversation. I want to share a little bit of some conversations I've been having with business owners lately, feeling some frustration around how do I hold my employees accountable, especially when they're working remotely. And the work I do with leadership teams, helping them really clarify their vision, increase traction, and really help to become more healthy, this falls under that dynamic of increasing traction. So we're increasing accountability within the organization. And the reality is, holding people accountable is really the same dynamics that happen whether they're working on site or working remotely. And I believe that accountability is really a byproduct of the strong leadership and the strong management that you're demonstrating within the organization. The overflow of that is accountability. And so there's three keys that I'd love to share with you today. Number one is starting with crystal clear communication of the expectations you have for that employee. And one of the things I hear oftentimes is, well, they know what they're supposed to do. My experience has been when you're digging down to the root of the issue and you're clarifying those expectations, inevitably they're hearing something different than what you've communicated, or maybe you've only said it once. We believe you've really got to hear it seven times to hear it for the first time. Or maybe there's a lack of an understanding of what you meant when you said it. So getting clear on those expectations is absolutely essential. Number two is defining a weekly measurable. So this is a leading indicator, some sort of number that defines what success looks like in their role with those expectations. Typically we use a scorecard, it's got a weekly goal, and then 13 weeks at a glance, so you know exactly whether or not they're meeting those expectations. The paper tells the story. With folks that are working off-site in this day and age, really being able to define what success looks like by numbers is absolutely essential. And then lastly is just getting that right meeting pulse in place with those employees, whether that's on a Zoom call or face-to-face, reviewing that scorecard and making sure that you're having those difficult conversations when those measurables aren't being met, holding them accountable, but also being able to be a resource as a coach to help come up with a plan for the development of that employee to make sure that they're getting to the point where they're consistently hitting those goals on that scorecard. And so combined together, the three of these really help to just indicate where that person's at from an accountability standpoint. Again, it doesn't matter if they're working on-site or off-site. When you've got these three pieces in place, that employee knows where they're at, and you're able to really at a glance see where they're at as well, and then have those conversations when necessary to make sure that they're consistently delivering in the way that you need them to. So if any of these things resonated with you, if you'd like to have a further conversation, my contact information is included in the post. And if you want to follow me on LinkedIn, you can follow me at hashtag Miracob or hashtag Gain Traction with Becky. Thank you for your time today. I hope you found this helpful.